how are you? I have some information on the race goals you should keep in mind.
They say that even a second is an eternity in Formula One, so going 4 winter months with no racing at all has seemed a very long time indeed. We're back though in Melbourne, home of the Australian Grand Prix since 1996. We go racing today then in the state of Victoria, where the drivers have 16 corners and 3.3 miles to navigate at an average lap speed of around 120 miles an hour. The close proximity of the barriers makes accidents inevitable, and recent history shows us that a safety car is not at all out of the question. I'm joined today in the commentary box, as I will be throughout this season, by a great racing driver, a former F1 competitor, man who was world champion once upon a time as well, and an all-round top chap. It's the one and only Anthony Davidson. And tell me, here we are, first Grand Prix of the season, the first time racing these cars. So what are the big questions that need to be answered here, in your view?
First of all, Crofty, and thanks for the glowing introduction. I just want to say it's a real privilege to be here, and I can't wait to see what this competitive field has in store for us this season. Now, to answer your question, obviously there's the question of performance in race trim, but really this is going to be all about reliability. It's the first Grand Prix of the season, don't forget. You're pushing all your new components to their limits. Formula One cars are full of very sophisticated but also very sensitive technology. So the most important thing today is to get to the end of the race, keep everything in good condition, and try to stay out of trouble while you're at it.
Okay, new season, and we're starting at the back. Let's see if we can do better in the race.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. Nico Rosberg will start his Silver Arrow from pole position, and Kimi Raikkonen completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Vettel, Max Verstappen, and Massa, Bottas, Button, Alonso, and Esteban Gutierrez, Hülkenberg, Perez, Romain Grosjean, and Sainz, Palmer, Wehrlein, Kevin Magnussen, and Daniel Kvyat, Harry Anto, and Ericsson, Felipe Nasser, and a Red Bull rounds off the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Thank you.
serious for G2 multi-year strategy due to change of state of play.
race.
some information.
Stuff from Mercedes today. That's another historic win. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Lewis Hamilton takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship after an excellent result. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Sergio Perez. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes move to the top of the table. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.